Ken Wambui, can I ask Ann Nyabura, can I ask Samson and Catherine to come up here? Can I, the people that have called up here, who represent everybody else that have been traveling to Eldoret, to Nakuru, to Kisumu, to Tanzania, to Uganda, to Ethiopia, to China. That will be the representatives. Very, very briefly. Just very, very briefly. Wambui, Ethiopia, sijui Dar es Salaam. Dar es Salaam, tuwapia ilikuwa namna gani?
Bwana asifiwe. Praise the Lord. Amen. I have been on the road, on the move, on duty, but nimerudi. We had victory wherever we went. The Lord has been good. His favor has surrounded me as a shield, according to His word.
Amen. Give it to this Chinese lecturer at Kenyatta University.
Praise God.
Amen.
Ni man hao.
Ni hao.
Thank you. You remember. I really thank God for His grace for bringing me back home. I thank God for the blue skies, for the clear air. It's a blessing. And I'm just here for 1 week. I came to attend a friend's wedding. My parents don't know yet, so don't WhatsApp them. They're not around. It's a surprise for them. So let's keep it that. God bless you all. I love you. I go back on Monday, next Monday. God bless you all.
Thank you. Is there a tomorrow to get to my talk? So that you are doing
well. Thank God we were privileged to go to Israel the other week. And it was great to see some of the places that we've been reading in the Bible. Jerusalem, Golgotha, the tomb, Mount Olives, where Christ went up, Garden of Gethsemane, we went to Jordan, and Mount Carmel, and many other places. We thank God, we were safely, and came back safely. Amen.
Thank you, Mugabo, I'm on with you,
praise God.
Amen.
Yeah, it was a blessing to go there. Thank God to be back. God bless you.
Amen. We pray that next time they can cook some of us, isn't it? Si umesikia tena ungependa kuwa pale. Yeah. By the way, hiyo sikuwa nimepanga, lakini kusema by the way. Si hata wewe unaweza zuka utupangie twende Israel wewe. Yeah. Upange tu na twende. Kwanza mati wewe unaweza. Watu wa biashara mko hapa mnaweza kutupanga na twende Israel ndege moja. Imejaa. Naiandikwe kwa upande Deliverance Church International Zimmerman. If you're visiting us for the very first time, we want to welcome you in the house. We are glad you chose to come and worship with us. If you will lift up your hand, most probably or most likely the right hand, because it looks like very, very good. If you're visiting us for the very first time, let's see where you have sat. We are glad you came to worship with us. The Lord bless you. Is there anybody else who has come to worship with us today? All right, let's ask our brother to stand. Let's appreciate our brother. Let's appreciate him. 1, 2, 3. Amen. Jesus loves you and me and all. The Lord bless you and thanks for coming. Please come again and we will get to know you. After the service, for that visitor of ours, we'll go break the ground. Then after we break the ground, somebody will lead you to a place where somebody was waiting for you. There is a pastor leadership that were waiting for our visitors today. They have a word for you. I've already preempted. When we finish the service here, tell your neighbor, when we finish the service, we'll go to break the ground. How does it feel? From 2012, a long journey. But today, we'll break the ground. I don't know. Would I do a Guinness degree? Tulipokuwa tukienda kuchimba mitaro, kule sukari, sikulama. Excitement, bwana. Nyumba ni ya nani ni yangu. Mitaro ni nani anachimba ni sisi. Why? I slept.
I told God to give me rest so that I can bomoa the ground there today, and we are so grateful to the Lord. I want to thank God for all of you that participated in the Conquerors Conference. First of all, the ministry team, if there was a cup, you'd get it. Because you came very early. At least there was one time I took a register and you were over 20. I was impressed. I also noted that every evening that those that were not able to be in the morning would come. So ministry team, I salute you. If we do it one more time, hii kanisa itaja. One more. I also want to thank those that came. Of course, I discovered that the coordinators don't come there every day together. Some, I don't know, they had a roster for Monday. Others did not show up on Tuesday. They came on Wednesday. Others did not come on Wednesday. They came on Friday. But thank you all for coming. Suppose we all come one day, all of us. Again, we'll fill this place. And it is doable, and it is also possible. Start preparing your leave for next year. I know some of you did not take leave at all, but some of you did. Like Josiah Nzuki. He was here every day. Alichukua leave. Amen. Thank you, Josiah, for making me feel, I felt very, very good. Of course, the ushers did a commendable job. They were here, they dressed up very well, they looked very good. We also want to thank the worship team. They were here, and they were really prepared. We also want to thank your Amani choir. They really sang very well, I think they beat the Tanzanians this time. They did very well, and we are so glad. If they continue like this, and I'm going to Tanzania, I will go with them. So hiyo ni kusema nikiitwa Tanzania, Amani team we tayari. Tikiti ya kwenda nitatafuta. Kwa sababu akiimba Kiswahili sitakuwa nimeokoka. Watakuwa wakifikiria hata mimi nitaongea Kiswahili akiniongea Kiingereza. And also thank you for those that came and participated. Everybody who came, we are so grateful. I also want to thank you, those that registered and never showed up, they never came. We have your badges. Thank you for putting faith in us. You know, you pushed us to prepare for you. Next time when you do so, please come. Because there are a few logistic problems that we found because of you and some cost. You prepared the badges, you had registered, and so on. So next time, register and come, and it will be great so that we don't have badges that are not used. Then yesterday we had the Family Day. Thank you for those that came again for Family Day. Deliverance Church International Kenya Family Day. We were in Umoja, Kangundo campus, and we were alive at KBC. Hapo tu ndio niliona ministry team amuku wako. Na niliona tu, unajua saa ingine unaonaga tu, lakini musijali, Omido alikuwa mahali umuumu tu, na Ubiero umuumu tu, lakini amuku wa vile vile. Nilifikiria vile vile ndio utakuja kule kule. But some of us came and it was great. Bless the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. How to respond to a really bad day? How to respond to a really, really bad day? You know, it is good for all of us to know that we have bad days. All days are not the same. Some days we wake up and, man, I tell you, what we pray, nothing happens. We pray for a certain direction, but we find the way becomes harder. And then the question is, now how do I respond to those days that are not very good, or I have promised something, or I have said something, or I have promised somebody something, and then I cannot fulfill. Something has gone off. It's not in the same direction that I wanted to go. By the way, I'd forgotten very special people. There was a team of five that they were not in the program. But towards 3 weeks before the conference, we put them in the program, and they handled the topic I gave them very, very well. Francis Obido, Pastor Wangombe, Pastor Mwithi, Simon, Brother Simon, and we incorporated as a brother from United States of Polokwane, who also fitted very well. And that was great. Actually, I felt so good. And I will use you again. You did so good. And you kwa mzuri sana. I don't know when I travel, I'll travel with you also. Maybe not all of you, because we're all pastors here. We can't leave the church without people. But I was so impressed by what you people did. Now, can I ask you something? And if I ask you, will you agree?
Yes.
I want you to stand and we read Job chapter 1. And I want you to read all verses that are divisible by 2. And I'll read all verses that are odd numbers. And I want you to open your mouth, because it will be on the screen. Just read what is on the screen, okay? And if your neighbor, you can't hear your neighbor, you hear her voice, okay? Hallelujah. There was a man in the land of Uz whose name was Job, and that man was perfect and upright, and one that feared God and eschewed evil. His substance also was 7,000 sheep, 3,000 camels, 500 yoke of oxen, 500 she asses, and a very great household, so that this man was the greatest of all the men of the East. And it was so, when the days of their feasting were gone about, that Job set and satisfied them, and rose up early in the morning, and offered burnt offerings according to the number of them all. For Job said, it may be that my sons have sinned and cast God in their hearts. Thus did Job continually. Said unto Satan, whence comest thou? Then Satan answered the Lord and said, from going to and fro in the earth, and from walking upon and down in it.
And the Lord said unto Satan, hast thou considered my servant Job, that there is none like him in the earth, a perfect and a upright man, one that feareth God and escheweth evil?
Then Satan answered the Lord and say, doth Job fear God for nothing? Or for naught? But put forth thine hand now, and touch all that he hath, and he will cast thee to thy face.
And the Lord said unto Satan, behold, all that he hath is in thy power, only upon himself do not fall in thine hand. So Satan went forth from the presence of the Lord.
And there was a day when his sons and his daughters were eating and drinking wine in their eldest brother's house.
And there came a messenger unto Job, saying, the oxen were plowing,
and the Sibians fell upon them and took them away. Yes, they have slain thy servants with the edge of the sword, and I only am escaped alone to tell you thee.
While he was yet speaking, there came also another, and said, the fire of God is fallen from heaven, and has found up a sheep, and the servants, and consumed them.
While he was yet speaking, there came also another and said, the Chaldeans made out three bands, and fell upon the camels, and they have carried them away. Yes, and slain thy servant with the edge of the sword, and I only am escaped alone to tell thee. Corners of thy house. And behold, there came a great wind from the wilderness, and split the four corners of the house, and it fell upon the young men, and they are dead. And I only, alone, have escaped to tell thee. I'll repeat that again, and please put some emphasis on the worship part.
Then Lord arose and rent his mantle and shaved his head and fell down upon the ground and worshipped.
And said, naked came I out of my mother's womb, and naked shall I return thither. The Lord gave, and the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Our Father, we pray that you speak to us. And Father, speak to us in a language we can understand. How do we respond when the day is really bad? Minister to us, we pray in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We may get seated. I don't know whether you sometimes ask yourself, why is this happening? Or whatever happens, you say, like people who say, it is the will of God. It was written. I have to go through here and go through there. But Job gets to a place, he discovers it is like a dream. Actually, it's a video, kind of. Because like we read, while this one is speaking, there's another one waiting. While this one is speaking, there's another one waiting. When actually, Job is not given even time to consume or to prepare to respond. Because before the other one finishes, the other one comes. And all of them have reports that are not positive at all. But I like his action. He goes down on his knees and he worships the Lord before he opens his mouth. Because you know what? If he opened his mouth before, I'm sure he could not have said what he said. But when he worshiped the Lord, then what came out from him was, naked I came, and naked I'll go. And God, you're the one who gives them all those to me, and God, you have the power to take them away. Bless the name of the Lord. Now, there is so much in this text, but I want to start where God asked Satan, hast thou considered my servant Job? Have you considered my servant Job? And first of all, I want to tell you that the devil, unless he's moving to and fro, he might not see. That's why he had not even spotted Job, because he was going to and fro, and he is not omnipresent. So at that time, he did not pass Job's place, but he had passed it before. So he had a report about Job. Hast thou considered my servant Job? Many people in the world today would not like being called a servant. Actually, all of us, we don't want to be called the servant. And sometimes we struggle. We struggle so much with our credentials, actually. We struggle so much that people have to know. I mean, they have to know. After all, they have to know. And I was so amazed one time I went to Kenyatta University in 1985. And we had a wonderful mission there. I think 85, 86. There was a wonderful mission. And The guy that was called there was called Dr. Brooms. He was from Guyana, some South America, and he was like the head of he was in the Assemblies of God, in particular PAG, and as a missionary in Machakos. And when we went to introduce ourselves, man, I felt, have you ever gone to introduce yourself and then you realize, Jamawana need to be dead one? Professor so-and-so, Dr. so-and-so. Engineers want to. Amen. And we were in the team. I was in their team. We had gone there to help the students, and I was in their team, eh? And we're introducing ourselves. So you can imagine when it comes to me, I said, my name is Pastor Jimmy. I serve the Lord in Zimbabwe. When I left, I felt like I would have said I went to Sweden. It would have added some little weight. Then I'm asking myself, so what? I've come to serve these students. How best can I serve them unless I get so close to them? Must they know I'm a professor in chemistry in the University of Nairobi Chiromo campus? Must they know I'm the director of Shell Company? Because those are the guys that, they are Christians, I knew them. Now that is not it, that was not the shocker. The shocker was, every day people got saved. Because Dr. Broome preached sermons that were easy to pick. Easy to pick. Miracles happened, students got saved. And I was in charge of the powerhouse. They came in and I prayed with them for salvation, for restoration, for power. And you know, there were some that would come crying because their life. Like one girl came, first year she had a baby. So she went home. No sooner she came back, she had another one. And here we are, and God has ministered to her, and he has come to powerhouse. And I was, every time I got home, I was feeling fulfilled by praying for these boys and girls and these guys in the university. Then when we finished, a comment was made by one of the engineers. This was very cheap. The sermon was very, it was not intellectual. Where I sat, I told the guys, because incidentally, some of them, half of them, we had also done mission at the main campus 2 years before that. And the speaker in the main campus was Adiemo. A guy that spoke so hard that the students were not even getting saved. Because he would leave them wondering. Those powerful theological terms. So I told the guys that were their friends, we were in Nairobi, some of us. The student there, very few of them got to know the Lord. But here, every Sunday, I mean every evening, when we were taking coffee with them, they were still getting saved. Hapa mnataka kuwa intellectual. You want to be intellectual in class, intellectual in church, intellectual everywhere. Now, the point that I'm bringing is that Job is told by the Lord. Have you noted? There is a man called Job, and actually, God called him my servant. But Job says something Satan says something about Job. He says, no, are you talking about the wealthiest person? Are you talking about the man who has this sheep, this goats, this camels? Are you talking about that man? That man is only you that has covered him. Take your hands out. Because you see, as far as the devil is concerned, he knows what you have. He knows why you have it. He knows why you are not losing it. Thank God the devil knows. So many people in the world today would not want to be called servants. That's right. They don't want to be called servant. They don't want to be. Don't call me a servant. I am nobody's servant. I am my own man. What I got, I worked hard for it. Who I am today is who I want to be. Nobody tells me to do anything. I am my own man. I don't want to be a servant of anybody. You seem to be a servant, actually. What it sounds like to be a servant sounds like this. To be a servant, then you have to serve somebody. Isn't it? You have to do something. When they tell you something, you remember the centurion who tells Jesus, I am a man of authority. I tell one, come, and they come. I tell another one, go, and they go. When they want you to do something for them, you do it without asking any questions. The word servant, that's why people fight against it. No, I'm not. You have never seen Nigerians come to this country. Christians, Nigerians. Oh, we have had conferences with them. And when they come here, they start talking very bad against their own. This is my brother. In Nigeria, he doesn't drive a Mercedes. He drives a Toyota. I mean, they have a way of pushing others down until now. And they have come here, they are all bishops, they are, you know, they are all apostles and so on. But one wants to be bigger, powerful than the other. Servanthood is something that people resist and they want to fight against. But it doesn't matter how you feel at the moment. It doesn't matter how late in the evening you have been asked to come and serve the master. It doesn't matter whether you are in holiday. If you are called, you go back. You simply do whatever it is that your master asks you for. And I'm speaking to people here that some of you have to change your... When you go for leave, you have to change your SIM card. Because if your boss calls you... Oh, there was one time we had gone to... This lady was getting married and we had gone to... Where was that? Sweetwaters. When we were coming back, we agreed with Alice. Ah, sisi hatutarudi Nairobi. Tuangalie nini hivi. Tuangalie pale tulale. Si bosi Alice naye alimpigia simu. Si alimwambia namtaka afike saa hii. Fika saa hii hii, kama sio saa hii ni sasa. Unafikiria tulilala? Servants. The really bad part of being a servant actually is that you don't get paid. Whatever you do, nothing. You don't get paid. At least monetarily. Now that's right, they really turn some people off. Because many people won't do anything without getting paid. You know, whatever you want to do is what is there for me. What can I get it? You know, there's a day I took my, the other day I took my mom to get Oshags. And there's a place that we never got stuck when we were going, but I thought we might get stuck when we are coming back. But there were people not very far from there. I think they were waiting for us to get. But there was a heap of soil there. And I asked a guy, do you have a shovel? He said, yes. Can you put this and fill that hole? Yes, I can. Then do it. Of course, I paid him. But I paid him cheaper than if I got stuck. I'm telling you, if you get stuck, you go up, they tell you, mdos. So I say, come out and give him me. Now, now, where you go to? Nasisi to an arena story said, yeah, but I gave 100. Yeah. Because it was 15-minute work. 100. But there are people who wait for you to get what? Because when you get stuck in a car, depending which car you are driving, they are so happy that this news. Sabu wezi toka. Napatapone makiope pate. Mzee, giri bi. Asabu yu kondani, giri ngapi? Giri alafu na diangali. Chukweni miatana, apana mzee. Kama una ngiri mbili, toka ujisukumie. However, if you are willing to pay them, they will basically do anything you want them to do. But to ask them to do something and expect absolutely nothing in return is absurd. Now, really bad is that servants are not expecting to be paid. But if you ask them to pay them, and you pay them, then they will do whatever you want them to do. There are servants like that. And that is the society that we are living in. We live in today. And basically, things weren't much different back in Job's day. In the book of Daniel, chapter 3, verse 26, then Nebuchadnezzar came near to the mouth of the burning fiery furnace and spoke and said, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, ye servants of the Most High God, come forth and come here. Then Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego came forth of the midst of the fire. Acts 16, verse 16. And it came to pass as they went to prayer, a certain girl or damsel possessed with the spirit of divination met us, which brought her masters much gain by soothsaying. The same followed Paul and us and cried, saying, "These men are the servants of the Most High God, will show unto us the way of salvation." That's what she's saying. And now I want to declare to somebody here, I want to declare to you today that I am somebody's servant and so are you. Well, not just somebody, not just anybody, and certainly not everybody, but I'm a servant of somebody. Hallelujah. I want you to know that when he speaks, you ought to listen, and I also listen. When he commands, you have to listen and follow, and I have to listen and follow. When he requires something of me, I freely give it to him. When he wakes me up in the middle of the night to do something for him, I do it, and you ought to do it. No matter where I am at, no matter what time of the day it is, no matter what the cost will cost me, no matter how humbling it is, no matter what others will say, no matter what they say about me, I am a servant of Jesus, and so are you. For as little, this damsel said, that they are servants of the Most High God. Most High God. I figure if you want to be somebody's servant, that person must be a God. And not just a God, it should be the Most High God. Amen? Amen? Not the God of money, because you see, if you answer to money, even in the middle of the night, I don't know what kind of a life you're going to live. Not the God of popularity, not the God of position, not the God of this world, not the God of self, not the God of the flesh, but God, the Most High God. Bless the name of the Lord. For you see, you are going to serve somebody. You are going to serve somebody. Someone's servant you will be in this life, whether you like it or not. You can say you are your own man and you do what you want, but you are going to do something some powers push you to. Jesus spoke in Matthew 25, the 25th chapter, and he spoke about this unprofitable servant. He spoke about this slothful servant. And he spoke of the good and faithful servant. Now, who are you among those servants? Are you the unprofitable? Are you the slothful? Or are you the good and faithful servant? I don't know about you, but if I'm going to be a servant of the Most High God, I want to be the faithful servant of His. Yes, I don't want to be a wishy-wishy servant. I don't want to be fickle. I don't want to be a sunny day servant. I want to be a servant through and through. Whether it is on a rainy day, I want to serve the Lord. For He is the Most High God. He is the Alpha and Omega. He is the beginning and the end. He is the first and the last. I'm going to be faithful, a servant to Him. Bless the name of the Lord. He is not only that, He is the bright morning star. Without Him was not anything made that was made. In Him is no variableness, no shadow of turning. He alone sits on the throne of heaven. He alone rules dominion and powers. He sets up kingdoms. He pulls some of them down. Governments are upon His shoulders. He is the wonderful, mighty God. He is the everlasting Father. He is the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of His government of peace, there is no end upon the throne of David and upon His kingdom to order it. Hallelujah. And to establish it with the judgment and with the justice. Hallelujah. That is Him that I want to submit myself to. It is this one who is Lord of lords that I serve. It is this one that is the King of kings that I serve. I'm so glad that the Lord I serve loves me too. I'm so glad. And this was the one that Job served in the days of his temptation. So it matters who are you serving in the days of your temptation. Because Job was serving that Lord, that King, that God who is everlasting, even at the day when his temptations came his way. You see, the devil did not want the sheep of Job. Because one thing that you should know is the devil has no farm. It doesn't belong to him. Jesus took all of them back and gave them to us. Kwa hivyo hakuna pahali pa kuweka mbuzi. Shetani hana. Pahali ya kulisha ng'ombe. Shetani hana. Kwa hivyo hakutafuta haku akitaka shamba ya Ayubu. Actually, he did not even want the children of Job. Because killing them, that's not what the devil wants. The devil wants to tempt you and put you in his side. So to kill them was not the idea. He did not want his money. He was not after his health even. He didn't want his position in the community. The devil certainly didn't want his wife either. He was not interested to take the wife of Job. No. What Satan wanted was Job's praise. What the devil is looking for is your praise. You know, sometimes we quarrel the devil. You are coming after my wife. You are coming after my children. The devil is not interested with your wife, with your children. I know sometimes we confuse and we think the devil is after your children. He's not interested. He's after you. Are you going to praise him when your child is sick? Are you going to praise him when you are yourself sick on the bed? Are you going to praise him? That's what the devil is after, your praise. Can you praise him? Can you praise him? Can you lift him up? Can you praise him? So Satan is after Job's own worship. What he desires was to take from Job was worship. The devil wants to take our worship away. If there's anything that the devil wants, is your worship. If you can guard your worship and guard it well, that's what the devil is after. All that he did to Job's home and family and wealth and hell was only the tip of the iceberg. For what he really wanted to destroy in Job's life was his heartfelt praise to Jehovah. No wonder you see Job, if you read the whole book of Job, you discover Job, after some friends came to him, he lost. He forgot a little bit. But in the middle, he remembered. He said, I know my Redeemer living. He remembers. Then they talked to him some more. Then he forgot. Then he took God to a court house to challenge him. Then God came down and Job remembered. Yes! Yes! That's it! He remembered. And no wonder when he remembered, then he is challenged to go and pray for those guys, and they are told to do something. Give Job some offering so that he can pray for you. That's what happens, because all what the devil wants to do to me, he wants to take my worship, he wants to take my praise away from me. It was that song in the midnight hour that he wanted to destroy. You know, some of us, even at the middle of the night when things are not going well, you sing a song and say, it is well, it is well, it is well. And the devil doesn't want you to say it is well, so he will pinch you some more. And you will continue saying it is well, drives him crazy and makes him mad. Let's make the devil mad. Let's make him really mad by praising him when he expects us not to, by lifting up the name of the Lord. It was the praise in the midst of the storm that he wanted to despise. Because you see, I told you, when these guys came, Job could not respond. Because before this one finishes, the other one. Ni mimi nimeokoka tu, na mwingine anaanza. Ni mimi tu nimeokoka na mwingine anaanza. Yani, umekaa pale. Na news unazopata ni news ambazo zinavunja moyo. Kwa mfano, uko mochari. Where you in the mochari? Mumeenda kuchukua mmoja wenu. Alafu mkiwa pale mnapigiwa mnaambiwa kuna mwingine naye ameanguka Murang'a, amepelekwa Murang'a mochari. Mko hapo. Alafu mnatoka pale mnaenda mazishi. Mkienda mnasikia kuna wengine walikuwa wakija mazishi nao wameangukia pale Karatini. I mean, the whole story, what is it for? What is it trying to do to you? is so that you lack praise, you lack something that can lift up the heart of the others. Because the devil, actually the devil is after only one thing that you have, worship and the praise that you give him. Because what we give the Lord scares the devil. Yes, it was the shout of praise. It is the dance that he had. It is the praise that he had in the midst of all the storm. It was the sacrificial offering of worship that he had that the devil was after. No wonder, even after this, chapter 2 starts again, that the devil showed up again. Now this time the Lord asked him, have you noticed my servant? And I think this time Job did not go anywhere. He was with Job. He actually made camp there. And he got shocked. Because after he destroys everything, this guy is still saying, God, I thank you that I came naked. And naked I will go. You gave my children. And you have taken them away. May your name be praised. The devil was there. So when he goes back, he tells the Lord, what you have done is that you have shielded him. You have actually shielded him. That's why he cannot. Hawezi kuzika. Chiondoe mikono yako kidogo. Now the Lord says, nimeondoa lakini moyo wake wachana nao. So, kile aliguza sasa ni mwili tu. Bless the name of the Lord. He took his health. He took his health. He took his wealth. He took his family. But Job still had a word to praise and to worship the King of Kings. What you could not take from Job and he should not take it from you is that one thing of worshiping God in the midst or in the middle of chaos that are happening. No one can take it from you. And that is your worship and your praise to God. Job said, naked I out of my mother's womb, and naked shall I return there. The Lord gave, and the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. I know some of us write that in the theology, but some of us don't believe it an inch. We take it, we copy and paste. But may God help us to believe it, that it is God who has given, that it is God who has taken. And we guard our praise and we guard our worship to the Lord. Bless the name of the Lord. It did not matter to Job what he had in this world or what he did not have. He was going to be a worshiper in the Lord. I wonder today if there are any worshippers even in this house. I wonder, are there worshippers in this house? Are there people that can worship God? Are there people here who are worshiping God even in the circumstance and the situation that they find themselves in? Are there worshippers that they have refused to be put into a cage or into a box because of lack of a job, lack of a spouse, lack of a child, lack of some fees? Do we have worshippers that can still lift up their hands and say, God, thank you. Thank you that I know English. That's when you have been pushed that you cannot go to the university and you lift up your hands and say, God, thank you, I went to class 8. And you are so glad that you did. Instead of the devil pushing you down so that you can see all that which you don't have. That you can see all that which you have in the Lord our God. No matter, it did not matter to Job. And I wonder if there is anyone who has found that at the worst of times, it is still time to worship God. I wonder if there is just one person in this house who knows that any time is a good time to praise God. Praising God. Praising God. Like David at Ziklag, his family is taken captive. His household is burned to the ground. His own men want to stone him. But he goes on to praise God. He says he will encourage himself in the Lord. He will stand in the middle of all what is happening and praise him and thank him. Hallelujah. Amen. Oh yes, to thank God. Like Paul and Silas in prison. They were beaten, yes. Their backs were laid open to the bone. They were in shackles. They were bound. They were humiliated. But there is one thing the Roman jailer could not beat on that, and that was their worship. Tie my hands, tie my feet, but my mouth is open to worship God and to praise Him. No wonder in the mid of the night, they were found worshiping Lord. Oh, I pray that God can lift us up to put us in a level that we can worship Him regardless of the situation we find ourselves in. Hallelujah. Yes, when Satan has tried his best, you can still have a praise for God. He pushes you to the down, but you can still shout to the Lord. Yes, He can hold you captive, but you can still sing His praises, the praises of God. You can still worship God in the middle or in the midst of whatever is happening to you. There's another man in the Bible that is called John. John, in the book of Revelation. Historians tell us John was boiled with oil. Hallelujah. And he refused to die. Though some of you can be boiled, but your time has not come, learn to praise God. Hallelujah. He was boiled, so they banished him to the rocky island of Patmos. Now they said, amekataa kufa na mafuta. Sasa tuweke pale, ana vidonda vya mafuta, tuweke pale achomeke na inzi na nini ya kufie pale. And the guy goes there, instead of wondering so many things, he sees the Lord. Actually, he speaks to us, and he calls us kings and priests. At that level, oh, bless the name of Jesus. So they banished him to the rocky island. This is where many people give up. You are taken to a rocky place. But for John, no, he didn't. John said it is the Lord's day. You know what, in fact, he says, I was in the Lord's day. I was. You know, in other words, whatever happens, he says, this is the Lord's doing. And he was able to praise and worship the King of Kings. I want to speak to your heart today. Because the thing is, what I have seen in life and to many Christians is whatever happens to them when things are not right. They'll come to me and say, Bishop, I believe we have been bewitched. Then I ask him, why? Is it because my father died, then my auntie died, then my brother died, then my cousin died, then my shosho died, then my son is sick, my husband, you know, actually they speak until you realize who you come hata wachia hapo anajiumiza. Because you see, I refuse to agree that there is a witch doctor who can come and bewitch my family as long as I'm alive, because I'm the defense of that family. So I will not connect myself with witches. See, nini wazee kidogo. Kuna watu, nini wazee kidogo. Kuna watu wakija kwenu, mtoto alikuwa hatolewi kwa hali amefichwa. Kwenu. Kwa sababu alisemekana kumuangalia na macho hivi. Never say man go. So there are people that, hey, mama fulani anakuja, mtoto chui anafitwa mahali pengine na huko ndani. Have you ever asked yourself, walienda wapi hao? Si wako tu, lakini hawawezi kuwa na power. Watachukua nyambura hivyo sema, kamutuna mazuri wakuzo. Now nothing. Why? The blood of Jesus. Amen. I pray that God can push us to that level. Tukiniangalia, sitalala. Niangalie, nitaenda nilale. Kwani wewe unabeba usingizi? Ati sitapita hii njia, kuna mama anakaa pale na akikuangalia hivi unasikia kizunguzungu. Wewe niangalie na kizunguzungu yako. I want to praise God. See, when we learn to lift the name of the Lord, where situations are bad, then God asked them for his good.
Yes.
Job did not know that God was enjoying the drama. It is God who was telling the devil where to go, because the devil does not know where to go. Some of you, the devil has been allowed to come to you. Si usimame imara, iyo ameiba, atarudisha mara saba. Alirudishia Job, na hata wewe, atakurudishia. But you have to know, you have not to confuse when the people are telling you, umefanya dhambi, unatafuta, hakuna. So utakaa pale ukilaani, ukilaani, kwa sababu wengine watakupa habari mpaka unakubali. Sijui kama wewe ndugu ushaenda ukamwambia mke wako kitu, alafu akakuuliza, ndio ile kuambia. Kwa sababu wakati mwingi wewe kuwa na original thought. So when you tell your spouse, anakuuliza mlikuwa na nani? Au huyo ndiye alikwambia, you know, and you can have so many stories. But I want us to be men and women who will praise God, because the devil is after only one thing. Can you praise him when you fail an exam? Then can you come out of hiyo umepewa result alafu unasema hallelujah, nimeepuka kizungu na nitarudia. What happens? Ukitoka pale ni kama ile act tulifanywa hapa during the conference. Amukuona wasichana walikuwa na uniform hapa, wamekuja na makaratasi wakiangalia. Si walifika pale wakatoa nguo wakatoa hata kile. Yaani wewe ni umekasirika. Ma result nini, ma report form? Natupa yote chini. When I have done my best, I praise God.
Amen.
Because my best could be 49 out of 100. But it was my best.
Yes.
And then I say, nikirudia this time, tachapa mia. Na unarudia, kwani? Wewe ndio wa kwanza kurudia? Na kwa nini umetoka hapa ni kama umefiwa? Let's learn to worship and praise God. The devil is after your praise.
Yes.
Na nikizungumza hivi nazungumza habari yangu. Najua shetani kile anatafutaga ni nikose tu kumsifu Mungu. Kwa sababu ninapomsifu Mungu, kuna mambo anafanya hata huko tu. Yanafungua milango mingi kabisa ambayo mingine hata mimi nashangaa. Lakini wakati nimekataa kufanya hivyo, naona ni kama mlima. Kwa hivyo siri ni kumsifu huyo Mungu. Siri ni kuinua jina lake. Siri ni kumtukuza Mungu. Kwa Ayubu, kile kilikuwa kikitafutwa, and I have shared this again here before. What the devil is after is not your money, but he might use it so that you learn to praise him. What he's after is not your health, but he wants you to forget the Lord to praise him for your health. Si tulipewa kisa hapa, na hicho kisa kimerudiwa mahali pengi. Huyu mzee ati alishindwa na kwenda mkojo. Si ameenda kwa hospitali. Akiwa pale si analipishwa pesa. Sasa akakaa chini akaanza kulia. Akalia. Sasa daktari akashindwa, ni pesa zile nimemwambia ama ni nini? Ili nimpunguzie. Ni pesa. Ni ile pesa tumekulipisha. Hapana. Ni nini? Nimekaa hapa nikijiuliza. Hii miaka 70. Sijatumiwa bili na Mungu. Na nimekuwa nikienda mkojo unajitoa mwenyewe. Sasa umekataa kutoka. Ili utoke mnanilipisha, sijui alilipishwa pesa ngapi. Sasa analia kwa sababu hiyo miaka yote amesahau kumsifu Mungu. Nasema hivi, hata wewe miaka hiyo 25, 30, 40, 50, wengine tumeanza kutoka 60 hiyo miaka. Bwana amekutendea mambo, umekaa chini na kumtukuza. Pengine hapa tunahitaji kulia. Kabisa kabisa, kwa sababu hii hewa tunapumua. You know, kuna wakati inakuwa lazima uwekwe na kitu. Na ni umekuwa tu ukipumua tu, ukipumua tu, ukipumua tu. Kwanza sisi ambao ni vijana, kukimbia kwenda tu na chini, alafu unafika pale mzee unachoka na kuinama. Alafu tuna we praise God. Let's learn, because the devil wants you one day usahau kumsifu kwa sababu umeumwa na mgongo. Na hii miaka yote tumepata baraka zake Mungu kwa wema wake. I wonder if there's a King David in this place who knows it's time to bring home the presence of God. Because David, when that time came, he went for the ark. And this time he was wise. He knew every six spaces, worship God. Every six spaces, worship. It took a whole long time to get to Jerusalem, but it went with the praises. Every six spaces. Now, every six spaces, learn to worship Him and to praise Him. Every a few steps, thank God for what is happening within you. And the devil will not catch you off guard. Worship Him, praise Him, every six spaces, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, I want to thank you, O God, because we know what the devil wants from us is to attack our praise. We want to guard our praises. We want to guard our worship before you in the mighty name of Jesus. When I was preparing to come and speak this, the Lord was showing there are certain people here. Oh, yes. They are wondering, how can they praise God? How can they worship God? Because of certain pressure that has happened to them. And they feel so low. This message was for you and me, that even at that lowest moment, we can lift up our hands and worship God. And you are saying, Bishop, I'm here. Yes, I might not even be able. Yes, God knows you're not able. But are you willing to give Him an opportunity to revive your spirit so that you can start praising God? So it doesn't matter where you are. It doesn't matter what happened last week or this month. The Lord can still come and lift you and give you victory like He did to Job. Only let's praise Him and worship Him. So if you are here and you are struggling to worship God and to praise Him because of the circumstance, would you stand on your two feet right now in the mighty name of Jesus? Blessed be the name of the Lord. My hope is built on nothing less
than Jesus' blood and
righteousness.
I dare not trust the
something in your life and start praising God. Actually, the things that have happened to you that have made you very low, stand on them and praise God for the things that He has done to you. Lift up your voice. Lift up your voice and praise Him. Lord God, I worship you even for the mighty project and projects that, Lord, you have brought me to. I want to thank you for the building project. Yes, I want to praise you for every stone, every cement, every worker. Yes, I want to praise you, Lord. I thank you because you are a God and beside you there is none other. Even as we break the ground today, Lord, I pray. Oh God, I pray. Oh Jehovah, I pray that we will praise you when we break the ground. We will praise you when the building is going on. And we will praise you when the building is finished. In the mighty name of Jesus. No other voice we're going to hear. We want to hear the voice of God. Father, there are people here. They have lost many things like Job. But they are praising you now. They want to lift up your name, O God. Father, may you repay them sevenfold. May you repay them that which they have lost. If it is health, if it is wealth, may you repay them, dear Father. In the mighty name of Jesus. Lord God, I know you're a God and beside you there is none other, and you're going to do something new in our lives and in our spirits. Blessed be your holy name. Hallelujah. Lord God, I thank you and I give you praise. I declare that your people have a living Father. Those that have lost anything like Job did, dear Father, because of our praising you today, we are walking, dear Father, into a new season where, dear Father, you're going to overflow us with your blessings. We thank you, Lord, and we give you praise in Jesus' name. Let's appreciate the Lord's name.